Hey guys, welcome to my channel, Convos with Kim, where we keep it pure, positive, uplifting, relatable, and especially real, okay? So it's been a while since I have shared with you guys and came on here to speak with y'all. I've just been really careful about just what I put into the world, and it didn't come from a place of not being authentic or anything, but I really think it's important to be cautious of what you share, especially with sensitive ears. And like, you never know who's listening, and although you mean good, you just still want to be careful about what you share. So what I'm talking about today, y'all, it has been like, it's been a while, it's been a long time coming for me to even get in front of the camera and share this. A lot of the things I'm sharing, some people have no idea about. They'll learn it in this video. But I've really just been back and forth debating if I should even share my testimony because of what people may think of me and how people may view me, or just so many, I guess you can call them valid fears. I guess you can call it that. But it's still selfish at the end of the day. But here I am, and you know, you have to take things out of, you know, look at things from a different lens. Yes, I have this fear. Yes, I have these thoughts and these connotations about how many people may think, but at the end of the day, this may be someone's prayer. This may be, you know, what someone's breakthrough. So here I am, being real with you guys, being pure with you guys. Start with basically how I grew up and what led to me rededicating my life to Christ, because your girl used to be out here just doing crazy stuff. And I think sometimes people think they're in too deep, that it's just like, why bother? Like, it doesn't make sense. But I'm gonna share with you guys my testimony, which I finally have the courage to, and I trust that God's grace is with me and has been with me, and that's why I'm able to share this with you guys on today. So I grew up in a house where we went to church. We went to church just about every Sunday, or well, on Sundays. I won't say every Sunday, but my mom did try to make it to every Sunday church gathering. So it would be me, my mom, and my sister. So we would try to make it to as many Sunday services as we could. I guess growing up, not to give every single bit, but I had an understanding of who God was. And who Jesus was. I'm not even lying. It took me until like I was way older in age to understand there was the Holy Trinity. Like, I would hear the Holy Spirit, I would hear Jesus Christ, I would hear God, but I didn't understand like the dynamic, I guess. And growing up, you know, I was taught to, you know, pray, knew to pray at bedtime, like before I went to bed. But I can honestly say I didn't have a solid relationship with Christ, and I really didn't have anyone who in my family was modeling a healthy, godly relationship with God, like a Christian man or a Christian woman who I was like, I want to know more about who they are or why they're doing that. Like, I didn't have role models, I guess you can say, when it came to, someone who was walking, you know, following Christ and walking, their life reflected it. I didn't have that. I can say that. So that affected me going forward in my relationships and just even how I was as a person. So fast forward to, let's say, high school. That's when I really began, I guess, having relationships or a relationship. I had one relationship. I had one relationship, I guess you can say. And yeah. One relationship, and I just had a misconception and a very vague understanding of, like, don't have sex before marriage. I was told that growing up, but it wasn't like broken down as to why you should not have sex before marriage, besides getting pregnant and STDs. Like, No one said anything about soul ties. No one said anything about emotional attachments. No one said anything about, you know, your body being a temple. No one saying anything about, you know, any of those things. It really was just vague. Like, don't have sex before marriage. You can get pregnant out of wedlock, or you can get STDs. So with this little understanding and knowledge, I maneuvered through life just, you know, okay, well, to not get pregnant, let's wear condoms. And for STDs, let's get tested. You know, like, it was just kind of like me finding ways to get around it. And it also just reflected in who I was as a person. Like, I just felt as though I had to have sex incorporated in my relationships. Like, how else would they exist if I didn't have sex? Like, you know, my body, you know, I look good. I feel like I can offer this to men, to guys. And, you know, it's something valid. And for a while, I had that mindset up until 2020. Yeah. So just 2 years, almost 2 years ago, that was my way of thinking. And going into more things that I was doing in college, you know, your girl was out here. Like, I was really out here. And like, I didn't have a solid relationship with God. I went to church. I can count on 10 fingers the number of times I went to church while in my undergraduate program. 4 years, you know, at my university, I can count maybe on 10 fingers how many times I went to church and actually, you know, listened to the word, understood it, applied it, you know, wanted to know more about it. That wasn't happening. I was going because, you know, maybe someone invited me, or I was going with my grandmother, or, you know, a friend was going, so I went. But I really wasn't into it. And I do remember one instance, I took a boyfriend at the time, my ex-boyfriend, to church. I was like, let's go to church this Sunday. We're going to go to church, then we're going to go out to eat. But like, I think at that point, something was starting to like push me, but I was just like, you know, not really tapping into it. I was just like, okay, I still was doing what I was doing, if that makes sense. So fast forward to 2019, when I got into a relationship, I still was at the same place. I was older. I was a little bit more mature as far as what I wanted, but I was still doing the same things. I was smoking weed. I was just out partying. I still had the same mindset. And it wasn't until, I'm gonna just, you know, fast forward. I'm trying to think, because yes, I was still doing the same thing. And then 2020, I remember, so 2020, I purchased and I was like, I don't want to do this anymore. Like, I don't want to do this anymore. And I said, this is the last time I'm using my money to purchase weed. So I was having these thoughts, like, you know, sporadic thoughts, but it still wasn't being pieced together. Like, I just was like, okay. Well, I'm not going to do this. I don't know. Like, it wasn't no solid reason. It wasn't a solid reason behind it. So, relationship, got into it in 2019 of July, of September. September of 2019. We started talking in July, but September we made it official. 7 months later, we broke up. After that, my life changed. I decided that I didn't want to continue to have sex as a part of my relationships. And when I made this decision, y'all, it wasn't because my body is a temple. It wasn't because my body belonged to Christ. Like, I hadn't got to that point yet. I just knew God placed it in my spirit. You cannot continue to do these things. You cannot continue to give your body away. And I just kept thinking, like, you know, all my relationships, the common denominator is me having sex in these, well, the relationships are ending for one, and then sex is involved in these relationships. Now, I haven't been in a lot of relationships, just the FYI. And I know previously I was like, you know, giving my body, I wasn't out here like giving it to everybody. Let's clear that up. But I, in my relationships, I did have sex, and I was just like, I gotta stop. Like, I can't keep doing this. And from there, okay, let me fast forward. well, let me back up a little bit. A few months prior to that, God began removing me from people. And it didn't make sense. Like, my interest started to change and I didn't understand. Look, y'all, I wasn't reading my Bible. I wasn't there yet. I wasn't at the place of wanting to rededicate my life to Christ. So I was still very much so in the world, and these things were happening. God began separating me from people. He began changing my interests, things that I like wanted to do. I was just like, nah, I'm not really feeling that. I'll pass. I would make excuses. I would make up lies, just anything to not be in that environment. And I didn't understand why. I just knew I didn't want to do it. I was still very much so in the world, but God was already changing and moving things before I could even begin to understand what was actually happening. So that's why I tell people, you're not too far out. Like, I thought smoking had such a hold on me. Like, I remember in college, it really had a hold on me. And it, you know, obviously when I graduated, it continued. It didn't just stop. And I literally thought, like, I could tell y'all some crazy stories, but, like, I was saying, okay, I gotta marry somebody who's okay with this. Like, I gotta date somebody who's okay with this because I can't stop this. Like, this is something, and I didn't realize the hold that it had on me. Same with sex. You know, we grow up saying, you know, you gotta do all these things. You have to test the car before you drive it. And what if you decide not to have sex and this person isn't good in bed, and what you gonna do now? And all these just crazy, you know, crazy thinking patterns that people still to this day are going along with. And you know, I'm not judging them at all. Everyone has their own process to getting to where, you know, God wants them to be. But I'm just saying, like, that was really how I was thinking. So yeah, so all that was happening, right? And I was just like, okay, you know, relationship ended. I'm not having sex anymore. So God began to remove people out of my life. And then I was still in this relationship. Maybe like a few months after. Okay, so that summer, July 2019, I really noticed the people being removed out of my life. And then I got into a relationship that lasted. And then beginning of 2020, April of 2020, we broke up. And then that's when everything happened. So imagine like a baby, right? And as I stated, I didn't have anyone growing up who I could be like, who I could look up to, who was walking the walk, you know, who was in church, who was serving, who was, following Christ, who life reflected it, a woman at that. I didn't see that. So I literally, well, now at this point, my sister, you know, I could look up to her. But when I was younger, I didn't have that. So imagine a baby, right? Learn how to walk. They have to learn how to crawl. They have to learn how to feed themselves. They have to learn how to use the bathroom. I was starting from scratch. I remember I purchased a journal. I purchased a woman's study Bible. And I also purchased a few books. So I just, like, I didn't say, God, I'm rededicating my life to Christ. I just knew that I wanted to change. Like, no words were really being spoken. I just wanted things to change. And I guess God knew my heart. Like, I couldn't verbally say what I wanted, but God knew my heart. He knew what time it was. And with that, he was leading me to different YouTube videos. Like, y'all, YouTube was like my best friend. I was on YouTube. I discovered Caroline Roberts' channel. I discovered so many channels. Like, I think Sarah Jakes Roberts. Like, I was just, it's like God was just like, okay, here's some women of faith, you know, follow them, look at them. It was like coming, like, people, like, I've been on YouTube before, but it's like their pages just begin to be visual to me. It was amazing. And I, like I said, I ordered books and I really began to be intentional. I joined a mentoring program at my church. I was going back and forth. I knew I wanted to be placed in a church home. I was going back and forth between the church I am at now and my mom's church. And I was just like, God, where do you want me to be? Like, again, it's all about intentionality. I knew that I wanted to change. I wasn't, you know, and it wasn't just a night and day thing. No, but I knew I needed to take some step forward to wanting to change. And God placed me at the church I am at now. And I was just like, okay, God, where do you want me to be? Because I wanted to be placed in a church home. So that way I can begin to, not saying this is the only way you can serve, but I wanted to begin serving in my church. And throughout these different videos and readings, I understood, you know, you want to serve others. You want to help others. Like, God just began to detox me. And the process has been like the journey. I won't say the process because it makes it seem like it's like a, I don't know. I don't like the word process, but the journey has been amazing. And it has been life-changing. And, you know, I have fallen short. I shared a video on this, August of 2020. So it was 5 months that I decided to, me and my ex broke up, and I decided that I would no longer have sex. I wanted to be abstinent until I was married. August of 2020, that didn't happen. I ended up giving into temptation, and I had sex with my ex. From that moment, watch the video if you want details on what happened, but you know that it was like, I cannot do this again. Like, I had never felt so much guilt and shame and just embarrassment ever. And only three people knew that: me, my ex, and God. That's it. But it still felt like the entire world knew it. But anywho, go watch that video. But I have fallen short. I am on this journey. I am learning every day. God's grace is sufficient. Sometimes I have moments where I'm like, who are you? Like, this is amazing. Like, I'm the woman that I needed. I'm the woman that I needed. And I have my moments like, who knew God would change me? Like, I used to be out here, y'all, like coming home all hours of the night, just getting drunk, like not caring, not being aware of my environments, like just out here living life like any way that I wanted to. And again, this is not to pass judgment on anyone. I'm just sharing my story and my testimony because this is my story and no one knows it better than me. And it's just so amazing what God can do. Like I said, you are not too far. He doesn't care what you've been doing, where you've been, what your thinking was, what you were praising, what you were idolizing. None of that matters. All that matters is that you dedicate your life to Him and that you choose Him. Choose Jesus. Okay? So, I've just become a better person. And the thing is, it's so funny. My personality is still the same. You know, like, my character has changed, my mindset has changed, my heart, God has been working on my heart, but my personality is still the same. So don't think that you know, when God brings you from out of living in the world, that you just like, you know, a robot. No, He still keeps your personality. He just molds you and refines you and makes you better. And that's really my testimony. I come from a life of just living in the world. If you can peep it, living, doing things of the world, right? So my shirt says, in the world, but not of the world, okay? So I'm in the world, I'm on this earth, but I don't define myself as being the things of this world, right? There's a lot of evil things of this world that I don't partake in. And I used to, but I don't partake in anymore. I just want to inspire someone, anyone who is going through a hard time right now, anyone who is wanting to not dedicate their life to Christ for whatever reason. Maybe it's your family. Maybe it's because of, maybe you think, you know, God is embarrassed of me. I'm scared. What would God think? Just know that you have to, the best thing I've ever done, and I always will say this, is create my own relationship with God. Not go off of what people told me growing up, not go off of what I see, what I watch, but actually taking time to create my own relationship with God. And, you know, people always say this, if he could change me, he could change you. But seriously, if he could change you, if he could change me, he could change you. Like, you're not too far out. But yeah, thank you for watching this video. I pray that, you know, again, this video comes across and resonate. I hope it resonated with you. And I'm grateful that I get to share my testimony openly and freely on such a platform as large as YouTube. And please look forward to more videos about different things that I discussed in this video. I do want to elaborate a little bit more on certain things that I mentioned. But yeah, if you have any questions, of course, you can comment them down below. And you can also message me if you want to be more private. Message me on social media. I'll leave that in the description box. But thank you for watching my video. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Hey, y'all. So something else I thought about just now, and I was like, let me grab my phone. Be gracious with yourself. Be patient with yourself. This is a process. Like, you can expect, like I mentioned earlier, you can expect to wake up one day and just be a changed man or a changed woman. That's not how it works. You have to be patient with God and patient with yourself, and also with the people around you. I think that when you're going on, when you're on this journey, you expect people to get things that, you know, to get it how you understand it and to interpret it, and you think they're on the same journey as you are. And most of the time, they're not. So with family and things, just be patient and just continue to allow God to, you know, change you and mold you and refine you and allow the Holy Spirit to lead the way. Because when you take things on yourself and when you try to speed the process up, it oftentimes backfires on you. Trust me, I know. So trust God, trust His plans for your life, and trust that, you know, being changed and being refined, it doesn't come easily. There's going to be things, there's going to be moments where you cry, there's going to be moments where you feel not heard, there's going to be moments where you feel lost, like you feel where you feel isolated. And I want to share in another video the season of being isolated and being in the wilderness and how that has been for me, and just things I recommend for you all to be, you know, to come out and to actually get through it. I think we hear the word breakthrough and we think that, you know, it's going to be easy or you're supposed to just stop in it. No, breakthrough means get through it. You have to get through it regardless of, you know, how hard it may be, how challenging it may be. So I just wanted to share that. Be patient, be gracious with yourself. Know that God has grace. His grace is sufficient, and just continue to learn from your mistakes. At the end of the day, you're human, and you're going to make mistakes, and we're sinful by nature. So there's going to be things, you know, we're all going to fall short someday. So yeah, that's all I wanted to share.